5 Lightning Quit Methods for Repaying Your Student Loans. Being a student already sucks for some because, I mean, who would want a load of schoolwork plus pay a student loan? I mean, I wouldn't want that. So, I've learned and mastered some skills on how to pay student loans fast. That's why in this video, I'll be sharing 5 methods that you can do to pay your student loans lightning quick. But before that, don't forget to subscribe. This is Finance Boss, an awesome channel for awesome people like you. Let's go! Number 1 is to start tracking your progress. It starts with figuring out how much debt you have today. So for me, it started with a simple piece of paper on the wall where I wrote my total student loan balance. And then, I updated every time I made a payment towards paying it off. And before that, I wasn't even sure how much total. So, you know, I just didn't want to know. So, I had this head-in-the-sand approach. But when I finally faced the truth head-on and then started tracking my progress monthly, that's when my student loan balance started to go down quickly. Sometimes, it feels like you have this mountain of debt. That's just never gonna go. But when you start seeing that number go down, it creates this incredibly motivating feeling of progress. And there's really nothing more motivating than progress. You know, even just making a little dent will motivate you to get out of debt even faster. And that increases your motivation even more and then creates this unstoppable snowball effect. So all you really need is a post-it note on your bathroom mirror or somewhere. You can see it every day and that's what I had. Number 2. To put $100 extra towards your student loans every month. Why $100? Because everyone can manage $100. You can either reduce your expenses by $100 or find a way to earn an extra $100. Examples of expenses you can cut out, for example, you can track lunch 2 times a week. That'll save you $12.50 for a total savings of $100 a month. You can cancel your gym membership, which is, you know, $100 usually, and you can work out in your living room instead. There's tons of free workout videos on YouTube, and a lot of you probably have a free gym in your building that you can use. It's all about being committed. Tip number 3. Once you come up with that extra cash to throw towards your student loans every month, it's time to decide where and how to apply that extra principle of payment. You have a choice between 2 debt payoff methods: the debt snowball or the debt avalanche. The debt snowball method is where you pay off your debt in order from the smallest balance to the highest, regardless of interest rate. For example, let's say you have 3 different student loans, $10,000 loan at 10%, a $2,000 loan at 5% interest, and an $18,000 loan at 6% interest. With the debt snowball method, you would direct your $100 of extra money towards the $2,000 loan first while making only the required minimum monthly payments on the other 2. Then, when that $2,000 loan is paid full, you would direct the extra $100 as well as whatever monthly payment you were making towards that first loan towards your next biggest loan. And then, you just rinse and repeat until all of your debt is paid off. The debt avalanche method, also known as debt stacking, is where you pay off your debt in order from the highest interest rate to the lowest. So going back to my previous numbers, you'd start paying off the $10,000 loan first because it has the highest interest. The motivation piece is huge. So much of finance and getting out of debt is behavioral. So the reason why the debt snowball is so effective, it's because you start seeing progress much faster. Most people who have a lot of debt and feel very hopeless. So it's very important to get that motivational push early on, which is exactly what the debt snowball is designed to do. There's also plenty of studies that show that the debt snowball method is more effective than the avalanche method, precisely because it's so much better for your psychology. I started with the debt snowball method, and I have to say, I'm really glad about that. Because in the beginning, I really just didn't see the light at the end of the tunnel. So, the debt snowball helped me start paying off entire loan balances, which fired up my motivation like crazy. And that's why I was able to make so much progress in just a few years. And now that I'm super committed to being debt-free, I switched over to the debt avalanche method because I no longer need that motivational boost, and I'm pretty disciplined with my payoff plan. So for you, if you're just starting out and feel super overwhelmed by your debt, I recommend starting with the debt snowball. Until you get some quick wins under your belt and you get that, you know, early boost of motivation. And then you can consider switching to the avalanche method later. once you feel like you've got the motivational juice to keep going. Number 4 is to consider refinancing any student loans with interest rates higher than 6%. If you have a good credit score, you'll probably qualify for something much lower than 6%, like 4% or even. And if you have someone who co-signed your loans for you, you might be able to get something even lower. Okay, now there are fees associated with refinancing, so it's not always worth it. But if you can lower your rate after accounting for the fees, then you'll be able to pay off your loans much faster. So consider looking into it and start shopping around. For example, SoFi has a free online application where you just basically put in some financial information about your job, experience, and loan balance, and then they'll show you what kind of offers and interest rates you qualify for. It only takes a few minutes and it's not a hard credit, so it's not going to affect your credit. Doesn't hurt to look. Number 5. And my favorite is to want more for yourself. We live in a society where debt is totally normalized. We've basically just become numb to living with debt, and almost everybody in America finances their college degree house, car vacations, and the average American. $6,000 of credit card debt, $30,000 of student loan debt, and most likely also has a car loan and a mortgage. But just because everyone around you has debt doesn't mean you need to be in debt either. In my family, I grew up thinking debt was normal, because whenever we didn't have enough money for something, it always seemed like just getting into debt was the answer, whether it was for college or a house or whatever. But consider that there are countries where people pay cash for everything, and if they don't have the cash, they just don't buy it. We have to stop resorting to debt to pay for things and learn how to delay gratification and just save cash for now, and to not just accept the status quo of being in debt. And this is stuff that society isn't going to teach you, because if everyone stopped financing their purchases and started paying in cash for everything, then companies wouldn't be able to sell as much, and the economy would probably slow down a lot. That is literally what keeps us trapped in the hamster wheel of consumerism and material. And, you know, just imagine what it would feel like to not owe a monthly payment to anyone anymore. And all the money you make would just go straight into your pocket instead of to other people you could start investing, so you can start making money on your money. You could work smarter and not harder. And that's why becoming debt-free is the first step to financial independence, and you can totally get there. Yeah, you might feel overwhelmed sometimes, but you got it. Sooner or later, you're gonna be debt-free without realizing it, and you can also be able to save in the future. Just don't normalize it in your life. Remove it, because it's a negative thing that can burden you for life. Well, you finally made it at the end of the video. Smile! If you're thinking of not doing anything and losing hope because you might have a lot of debt, think again. You got this. Well, yeah, this is Finance Boss. Subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Bye!